On this episode of Travels with Bill, we're in Durban, Manitoba, and we're actually going time traveling. This is Durban in 2022. You see a fertilizer shed, a couple old chemical sheds, but you certainly don't see any elevators. There used to be two of them here, but today is the story of what happened to one of them. Back in 1966, Manitoba Pool Elevators built themselves a beautiful new elevator. This is an aerial shot of Durban that shows both the Cargill elevator and the pool. We'll switch here to look at just the pool itself. Now, I remember that elevator from when I was quite young, but it didn't go on forever. It was June of 1995 when tragedy struck. Just after 6 a.m. on the 15th, lightning hit the elevator during a thunderstorm. It caught fire and there wasn't anything fire crews could do. Throughout the morning, the elevator burned to the ground. When the fire was finally out, the elevator was the only victim, although it very nearly took the entire town. And to understand exactly what happened that morning, we really need to go back to someone that was there and some videotape of the original fire. This was filmed by the Swan River Fire Department when they arrived about 40 minutes after they received the initial call.
We're in Durban, Manitoba. We received a call 40 minutes ago, 45 minutes ago, to respond to a lightning strike. This is the pool elevator. The top was on fire when the engines arrived.
Now, I'm not going to do a lot of talking here because the original video actually has commentary in it from one of the Swan River crew members who was running the camera.
You got the Benito Fire Department working at the west end here. Firefighters and volunteers starting to empty out some of these fertilizer sheds, getting a lot of the chemicals out of here.
Now, I was there that morning. I was 14 years old, and in fact, I drove one of those trucks getting chemicals out of that shed. If you watch really close, in fact, I think you actually see a quick shot of me in the video. You can't be at a scene like this without remembering it forever, and to me, it's extremely vivid. I was 14 years old, and I remember it like it was yesterday, and I'm sure almost everybody you see in this video remembers it as well, because it was a huge deal for an elevator to catch fire and slowly throughout the morning burn to the ground. This video is about 42 minutes long, and I'm going to let you see the entire thing because I don't want you to miss any of it. It does skip through, but there's a couple things you should watch out for. Another storm system comes here after a while. You can see it starting to build in the west already. When it arrives, the winds shift and the elevator starts to blow into the town site of Durban. There's a huge ember storm. That's captured in the video, and you can see the huge chunks of elevator flying over onto houses and shops and all sorts of buildings. Had it not started to rain, the chances are the entire town would have burned to the ground that morning. But it did rain. It rained and it hailed and it stormed and it put the embers out. Towards the end of the video, they'll actually show you the embers laying on the ground where they aren't now, and you'll see just how bad it was and how close it came to not just being the story of the Durban elevator burning down, but the entire community being lost as well.
Did you gentlemen see that? A few seconds ago there was just kind of a pop and the entire roof on the lower part went into flames there.
I'm going to leave you with the video with the original audio so you hear that elevator crackling, popping, and exploding as it burns. You'll see that second storm come in. You'll hear the thunder from it as well. And you'll also hear the commentary from the original gentleman that was here filming. Of course, this was a big deal for the firefighters too. And without them,
came through that door now.
Things would have been much, much worse. So a special thanks to all of them. I know it was a very long time ago now, but those of them that are still here certainly remember the fire and probably haven't seen the video in a while. We'll see you next time on Travels with Bill.
At this point, there's not too much the firefighters can do on this type of a fire. They're moving equipment as quickly as they can. You can see at this point the smoke is starting to come through the other end of the annex here for the office part. now on the annex deck. Another explosion inside. nature, up in smoke. control some of these embers. It's still raining even now, a little bit. But we had a good downpour with lots of wind and hail. Going a couple hundred feet in the air over it. see the main structure is coming down now. A lot of grain has come down and smothered the fire underneath itself. A little more effort down to the far end there now. The guys are making sure that the roofs are kept good and wet. They sprayed a lot of water on those fertilizer tanks. They claim if that fertilizer gets heated up, it'll just turn rock hard and really have an awful time getting out of those tanks. So the guys have put an effort into keeping those cooled down. Excellent response by farmers in the community with extra water trucks. Team Landmark came in with a tanker full of water. Valley Water, the Harris boys have been going non-stop here, lots of water. Lots of guys trying to help keep our water supply going here. We've laid a 4-inch line here that even as I speak, the guys are just charging it right now. And we're going to supply a little bit more water down to the far end here. There she goes there. So the Swan River Engine 3 is going to supply more water for the Benito end of the site there. Not too much they can do, just to, you know, protect the exposures. You can see the embers on the roofs. Even on the ground in front of us here, all these black, those were embers. We had an incredible firestorm at one point. Went all the way back, all around our equipment. All these roofs were covered with embers, and we got a really good rainstorm. Good heavy downpour, and certainly took care of our ember problem for a little while. Pool Elevator, Durban, Manitoba, the 15th day of June. We've had every kind of weather except snow this morning. Distance to see much. I can't get a whole pile closer because my batteries are dead and I'm running off of the generator. get a one-sided view of this fire. All the power is off in town, so can't plug in anywhere else. back to town. Leave this up to Benito. Looks like the worst is over.